basketball team. As a senior, he led Quinnipiac in points, led him in scoring, and he currently ranks fourth in Division I and 14th all-time in points and third in Division I rebounds. But the beauty of all this, I think, is while his accomplishments are outstanding, you knew what you were going to get every single day in practice and in games. He was a blue-collar guy. He brought his lunchbox to the gym every single day. And as you look at everything he's accomplished, when you really think about it, his dependability might have been his best ability. After a successful career here at Quinnipiac, he played overseas, and Quinnipiac called him back, and now he's Senior Associate Director of Admissions at Quinnipiac University, and he continues to have an incredible impact on this institution. I'd like to congratulate Hall of Fame inductee Bill Romano. Bill, you're going to get your plaque. You know, take a picture with Jack and John, and then the mic is yours.
Thank you, everybody, and thank you to Billy Mecca for the kind words, most of which I assure you are actually true. I had a long 12 to 15 minute speech planned out for you, and I've been working on it now for a couple of days. And being that I'm the first of 9 speakers to come up here before they open the bar, I promised my brother that I'd make it as quick as possible. I want to thank Quinnipiac University as a whole. I want to thank the powers to be that make this day so special, Dr. John Leahy, Bill Mecca, Jack McDonald. I can't even begin to tell you how honored and happy I am to be here today. And to speak what Bill Mecca was saying, to echo what he was saying, it's amazing to me to see how far this institution has come. And Coach DeSantis and Jared here will tell you, my freshman year in 1998, the locker rooms in Burcon Court were so small, we could barely fit the entire team in. The first Division I game against Army, I remember looking around and saying, wow, this is almost similar to a middle school or a high school locker room. And now look at this palace in which these home men's and women's basketball teams compete. It's pretty impressive. And kudos to Joe DeSantis for what he started here, certainly. I feel very lucky and fortunate to be here today. When you think of the experiences and opportunities I was awarded for basketball, more specifically basketball here at Quinnipiac, it's pretty remarkable. I mean, to be offered a full scholarship here, to get a great education, to compete at the Division I level, and be able to go on and graduate afterward and play a game that I love for my livelihood, all because I could put a ball into a basket that was 10 feet high. And Coach DeSantis and the rest of my teammates will tell you that's pretty much all I did. Wasn't much of a defender, wasn't much of a rebounder, but I could score it for sure. So congratulations to the rest of the inductees here, some of which I know, have known for quite some time, some of which I'm getting to know today. Certainly a special congratulations to my close friend, Jared Agrasso. I met Jared. When you think about your experiences as a student athlete, and you think about the highs and lows, a lot of times you think about the academics, the successes on the court and off the court. For me, a lot of it was the people that you meet. And before I set foot in a practice or a game, before I sat in a classroom, I had the opportunity to meet Jared Agrasso at orientation, the orientation we both decided to skip. And during that orientation, Jared and I became extremely close. And I'm extremely flattered to be here today, but kudos to the voters that allowed me and Jared to share this day together. It's very, very special. I have a few thank yous here. Certainly, a good Italian-American boy that I am, I'll start with my family. Tom, Amy, Jessica, my other brother, Cugino Tom. I really appreciate all you've done for me during my playing days, and I also consider you guys not only my siblings, but my closest friends. Mom, Dad, there's really not enough time to thank you the way I properly should. You've always allowed me to go through high school not needing to feel that I need to get that Division I scholarship. I was very fortunate enough to see college, higher education in my future, regardless of whether or not it was on a basketball scholarship, and I can't tell you how much that means to me. I remember my mother driving all around God's green earth in a 1986 Ford LTD that maybe still had one hubcap to all these AAU showcases and everything else. And again, you're a big reason why I'm here, and my siblings will appreciate the fact that despite the frets, I never had to walk to practice. My wife, Lindsay, thank you so much for all that you are and all that you are to me. You have the patience of a saint. You're an amazing person. And it was always easy for my inner circle of friends and classmates and dorm friends to be there when I was winning, be there after great games, to say congratulations, to celebrate. It was Lindsay that was there for me by my side through thick and thin, good, bad, or indifferent, and I can't thank you enough for all that you do for me. And I'm so thrilled that Lindsay's family is here today. They made the drive up from New Jersey, as they have done so many times in the past during my playing days. None of this would have been possible without Joe DeSantis. From recruiting me out of high school, to having the faith in me to start me as a freshman, to developing me into the player that I am and the person that I am today, you're a big reason why I'm up here, Coach. And I appreciate all you've ever done for me, and I can't begin to thank you enough. Consummate family man, class act, and again, thank you for all that you've done for me, Coach DeSantis. I'd be lying to you if I said that I was up here and the feeling that I'm feeling right now is not a little bit bittersweet. This past July, Quinnipiac University lost one of our own, and several people in this room lost a close friend. Father, friend, coach, counselor, brother, husband, Jim Kirby wore a lot of hats during his time here. So in closing, I want to say you will be missed. Thanks for everything you did for me as a friend, and I made it. I'm finally part of your club, Skip. And to the audience, thank you and enjoy your night.